hit it, bro. Hold on, that's on my element. I like dark skins, love a melanin. Huh, question Louis Vuitton when I'm stepping in. 30 bottles of the Zoom till I'm cinnamon. I had the Lambo, switch to the Rari. I'm a gangster, but I like to party. Pop a perky, go retarded. I'm a Brooklyn nigga, I'm cold hearted. That's why I like
it. Hey babes, and welcome back to my channel. It's Amira. Don't forget to smash that like button, leave a comment down below, and most importantly, don't forget to subscribe. Now let's get into the video. Okay guys, today is going to be a story time. I haven't done a story time in a long time because I've been gone. So without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so today's story time is going to be on how I broke my ankle, not once, but twice. So the first time I broke my ankle, this was in 2018. I was a sophomore in college. It was me and my mother, my nephew and my niece, and we left out of Family Dollar and we were going to the beauty supply store. So I was walking, and normally I look down when I walk, like every once in a while. Like I won't look down while I walk the whole time. Like I'll just look and then I'll just keep walking to make sure that I'm not stepping on anything, tripping on anything, whatever, whatever. So this particular day, I did not look down while I was walking. I don't even remember. All I know is that I went to walk and like my ankle went, my left ankle went. I'm like, I didn't know what to do. All I did was scream and I fell. I'm like, ah, my ankle. My mother like, you okay, get up, you good. I'm like, I don't think I'm good. I got up and I couldn't put pressure on it. So I'm like, something is not right. So I held on to her and she helped me walk to the car. So I still couldn't walk on it. So I had to hop. When we got home, I had to hop all the way up like two flights of stairs. And when I say it was swollen, it was huge. It was like this. My whole ankle was like this big. I'm like, something is not right. She like, you okay? I'm like, I'm not okay. This is, look at it. This is not normal. So she had to go to work. So I was at home by myself. I'm like, I don't know what to do. So I put ice on it. The ice wasn't working because it was still big as ever. I'm like, I called her like, ma, something is not right. Like something gotta give because it still shouldn't be this big. Mind you, hours had went past. It was like 7 o'clock at night. I'm still looking at it like this is not normal at all. So she called my stepfather and she told him to take me to urgent care. So I'm like, okay. So I had to limp down the stairs into the car. We went to urgent care. At this time, I think I was 18, so I still could go to the PM pediatrics urgent care. So we went there, we waited, they called me back, they took x-rays, and lo and behold, my ankle was broken. Now, I'm slow, so at first, I never knew what a fracture meant. I thought it was like, it wasn't broken, but it was like, something was wrong with it. I didn't know fracture meant broken. Mind you, I just learned that term like a year ago. I never knew what fracture meant. I thought it just meant something was wrong, but it wasn't broken, you know? Or is it just me? Anyway, so they took x-rays and a piece of my bone chipped off of my ankle. So my ankle was broken. I'm like, this is not okay. So they gave me crutches and they put me on an air cast. I was just fed up. I'm like, this can't be life. Like, I'm too young to be breaking bones. Like, are you serious? And then I can't walk at that? I was sad. I was so sad. But for some reason, it healed fast. Like, I was back walking within like 3 weeks, 3-4 weeks. So I guess it wasn't a bad fracture or whatever. So that was that. I was healed. I mean, it still was hurting here and there, sore, like aching. Like I could still walk and stuff, but it was like achy. So that was the first time I broke my ankle. Now the second time I broke my ankle was last year. Mind you, this quarantine was still happening. I had just turned 21. I'm still 21, but I had just turned 21. My birthday is August 12th. I broke my ankle on August 16th. I just had turned 21, so it was no bars for me, no lounges for me, no clubs for me, no nothing, because I was all broken up. I'm like, are you freaking serious? I was I had it up to here. Okay, I had it up to here. God is trying to tell me something. Let me know what, because I was so angry. Now let me tell you how I broke my ankle this time. I was at my best friend's house in PA, and all of the kids was in the pool. My nephew and my little cousin was spraying me with water. They was spraying me with a water gun or whatever. So I kind of didn't want to get wet. So I'm like, let me just play with them. And I ran, because they was going to chase me, of course. So they chased me. And as I was running, I ran by the pool. The grass was wet. I slipped and my ankle went, mind you, it's the same ankle. My left ankle, the ankle I broke 2 years prior. I'm like, are you freaking kidding me? So I didn't know I was going to fall. I just was running. And I had on Vans, so I'm like, oh my God. So I slipped, fell, and I heard and felt my ankle crack. I was like, not again. So one of my sisters was on the porch, she was laughing. I'm like, no. I immediately started crying. It immediately started to swell up. I'm like, no. This is not funny. Like, something is wrong. So I'm like, I yelled my sister's name. I'm like, get the rah. So my older sister, she came out running. Then my second older sister, she went in the house, got them, they came out. I'm like, my ankle, my, all ugly, crying hard, like snot, tears. It hurt worse than the first time. This pain was so unbearable. It was ridiculous. Like, I cried for a good hour. My older sister's like, why are you still crying? I'm like, because it hurt. Mind you, we live in New Jersey. We're all the way in PA. I had no insurance card on me. I couldn't go to Urgent Care Hospital out there. I'm like, I can't. I'm like, not again. I was in so much disbelief that I broke my ankle not a second time. I'm like, it's not giving what it has supposed to have given, like, at all. I'm like, yo. So time went on. And we ended up leaving. I was in the worst pain of my life. Now, when we were there, it was swollen. We got in the car. Car ride was like an hour, 30 minutes. When we got to urgent care, it was like this big. I'm like, oh my God. What? I was baffled. Now, I had to hop inside of urgent care. I'm like, oh my God. Mind you, I waited for a good 45 minutes to an hour to get back there. I get back there, they take the x-rays, they like, it's most definitely fractured. They never use the word broken. They always use the word fracture. So I'm still slow, not knowing what the word fracture means. So I'm like, oh, fracture is not bad. She like, no, it's a bad fracture. I'm like, okay. The doctor, she was like, we can't do anything for you here because it's an unstable break. I'm like, what does that mean? I'm already scared. So she like, we're gonna send you to a hospital. She called, told them that I was on my way, blah, 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 blah. So she was like, don't eat or drink anything just in case they have to do surgery. Now me and surgery, we don't mix at all because I'm terrified to go into anesthesia. So I'm like, huh? I'm like, wait. I immediately started crying again because now you're scaring me, because now I'm thinking I'm about to go to the hospital and they're about to wheel me up to the OR and I'm about to get surgery on my ankle. You got to be careful of the word choice you use. The nurse was like, no, because at this point she was wrapping up my ankle because I didn't have anything on it. So she wrapped it up so it could stay stable. So she like, no, baby, don't cry. I'm just saying. I'm like, huh? That's not making me feel any better. You already said the word surgery and don't eat or drink anything else. So now my mouth cotton, I'm starving, and I'm just like, you know what? So we went to the hospital. They claiming this is the wrong hospital because this hospital has two locations. So I'm like, mind you, the doctor told us to go to this specific hospital, and now you're saying that the orthopedic that's at this hospital is not at this hospital. He's at the other hospital. Now everybody is all confused and what? Mind you, it's like 10 o'clock at night, 10, 11 o'clock at night. I was fed up and hurting and thirsty and in pain. I'm like, yo. So we go to the right hospital, waiting. So it's like 1 o'clock in the morning. I got into a room, I'm still waiting. I had to take a urine, make sure I wasn't pregnant. I hate hospitals. Mind you, I couldn't even stand to go to the bathroom to take the urine sample. So I'm like, I'm looking at the nurse looking at me. I'm like, I can't stand to go to the bathroom. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Embarrassing. She was like, do you want me to wheel in it's like a thing that older people use when they can't like walk and stuff. It's the thing that they sit next to the bed. It's like gray and it's like a thing that goes in the middle and you pee in that. I'm like, I have to use that. She was like, baby, if you can't stand up and pee, then yeah. I'm like, oh my God. I was so embarrassed. I'm just like, are you freaking kidding me? Like, I was so over it. I was over it. So I ended up taking the urine. I'm like, can you come get this thing out of here? Because I don't even want to look at it anymore. So my sister ended up leaving. She went home to get us some jackets and stuff because it was absolutely freezing in the hospital. So she went home, got us some sweaters. She came back and she had something to drink. And I'm just looking at it like, I'm so thirsty and I can't drink anything. So I had to take a MRI. Was it an MRI or was it a CAT scan? It was one of those. One of those, the big old machine, you gotta lay down, you can't move, and it goes in a circle like this. I'm just like, this has to be serious if y'all doing all of this. So we're waiting. I came back from the CAT scan or MRI or whatever it was, because I can't remember. Waiting. So now it's like 2:00 in the morning and we're still there. I'm over it. We both going in and out of sleep, dozing off. Finally, the orthopedic comes in. He was like, you broke your ankle. It's fractured. We're going to give you an orthopedic to go to so he can check it. So I stopped him. I'm like, I don't mean to cut you off, doctor, but just answer me this. Will I need surgery? He was like, no. Oh, no. I'm like, I'm thinking to myself, why did this heifer tell me that I needed surgery? I was mad. I'm like, I was mad, but I was relieved that I didn't need surgery. I'm like, okay, thank God. So they wrapped me up in this weird looking thing. I was over it. So I go home. I had to literally sit on the stairs to scoot up the stairs and then crutch to my room. I was so over it. I couldn't believe it. I'm like, you did it again. You're clumsy. Like, what is wrong with you? Now, I didn't walk from August 16th until like the beginning of October, like / middle of October. I was out of commission for a long time. I didn't walk for 2 months. And I do not use this word lightly, I was depressed. When I say I cried every other day, because it was summertime, I was still out of school, and I couldn't do anything. I couldn't go out with my friends. I couldn't go out with my sisters. I couldn't go anywhere. I was missing everything. Depressed wasn't even the word. I don't even know what word to use, but I was like, I cried every other day. I'm like, it was nothing for me to do. Like, it was literally, all I did was crutch up and down the street. I had lost a lot of weight in my leg. That I broke my left leg, when I say my thigh was like the size of my arm, my thigh and my shin was like the size of my arm. Mind you, I'm not a skinny girl. So it's like, my right leg was big, giant, ginormous, and then my left leg was so skinny. I'm like, are you serious? It looked just so abnormal. Then my ankle looked it freaking disgusting. Like, it was all types of colors, purple, red, black. I'm like, what the? I was over. First time I went to the orthopedic, I ain't even gonna lie, I literally almost punched the doctor. Like, because the way they was doing it, they had took an x-ray and then they was like, oh, da da da, oh, you might need surgery, da da da. So I'm looking at my mother, I'm about to start crying. She like, don't do it. I'm like, I was so over it. I'm like, are you kidding me? Now y'all talking about the surgery thing again? Like, what is going on? The doctor, mind you, it was an intern and it was a doctor. The intern was doing all the work while the doctor was just standing there. Now, I almost punched the intern, not the doctor, because the way he had it, my leg was like stretched out like this. And then, because my ankle was like, my foot wouldn't go like this. It was like stuck like this. So what he was trying to do was make it go like this so he could see something or whatever. But it hurt so bad because he was like trying to force it to go up like this. Mind you, it was stuck like this. He trying to force it to go up like this. I'm like, I was crying. My mother like, wait, you're hurting her. I'm just like, eh. So he was like, either we can do surgery or we can put a cast. I looked at my mother so fast. I'm like, cast? We're not doing any surgery on me, no, because that healing process is even more than what I'm healing now. Like, no. So my ankle was big still, big, swollen, ugly, all types of colors. I'm like, this is not it for me. So I ended up having to get a cast. I have to have the cast on for 2 weeks. I went to that orthopedic 2.5 weeks after I went to the emergency room. So I had to keep on the cast for 2 more weeks. And then I went back 2 weeks after that. They took it off. And then I couldn't walk for another 2 weeks because they put an air cast on. But it was so nice seeing my leg because the cast was like all the way up my shin. I'm like, oh my God. When I say my leg was so hairy, I'm like, oh wow. This is ridiculous. It looks like I don't even care about myself. It was just too much. I couldn't walk for another 2 weeks because I had the air cast on. So once those 2 weeks went by, I was scared to walk. I'm like, what if I just put pressure on it and I just break it again? Like, I was so paranoid and I was so scared. I'm like, I don't know what to do. So it took me like a week to start walking because I was terrified to put all my body weight on my leg. I'm like, yo. So I was still using the crutches. My mother like, if you don't, she took them from me. Matter of fact, she was like, give me them because you have to walk. I'm like, what? Nope. She took them. I'm like, oh, wow. So I was hopping. I was still scared to put pressure on the foot. So I was hopping on my right leg still. But then as the days went on, I caught myself. At first, it was my tippy toe. So I was walking limping. I was like limping on my tippy toe, but I was putting a little bit of pressure on it. More days went on and I was limping, but I was walking. My foot was on the ground. I was walking limping still. And as the days went on, I was walking regular. My ankle was discolored after that for a good 2 months still. It's actually still discolored just a little bit. It's weird. I'm just so grateful I didn't have to get surgery because I was over it. I was completely, utterly over it. I was depressed for 2 months, didn't walk, missed out on everything. Mind you, we're still in quarantine. We're doing online schooling. I was just over it, to say the least. I'm just grateful I'm back walking and doing whatever I gotta do. You won't catch me running, skipping, hopping, anything, because I don't wanna harm myself. Now, mind you, I was just at the beach the other day and I was playing volleyball. Like I was playing volleyball. I don't play sports. I don't do any extracurriculars. I don't work out. I don't go to the gym. I don't do anything. So for me to literally be diving in the sand and jumping and stuff like I was like, oh, you're trying it, because we were in the sand. I buckled my ankle once, I think. I'm like, oh, see, we gotta stop because I'm not here for this. So we ended up stopping. But the volleyball game was... Moral of the story is I broke my ankle twice and I was over it twice. But the second time around, it was way worse. Because the first time around, I was back walking in like 3 weeks. The second time, I didn't walk for 2 months. 2 months! Never again. You will not catch me running unless I literally have to. Unless someone's chasing me with a pistol, you won't catch me running, hopping, skipping, jumping, leaping, nothing. Unless I literally have to. So those days, I'm over it. And yeah, when it rains, my ankle still hurts. Some days when I walk too much, I walk too far, it still hurts. But it's okay. I don't even care because I'm walking on 2 feet. Thank you guys for listening to my crazy story about how I broke my ankle twice. I still don't even know how I broke it twice. Not once, but twice. But whatever. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and comment and subscribe, and don't forget to click that bell button. It's right next to the subscribe button, so when you subscribe, you might as well just click the bell button to get notified every time your girl posts a video. But I will see you guys in the next video.